Hello, my name is Cheryl Recker. I'm a senior research and lab technician for the University of Missouri, and I'm located at the Horticulture and Agroforestry Research Center in New Franklin. We like to call it HARC for short. This video is about an ongoing research project here at HARC. The name of the research project is Expanding Watermelon Production and Market in Missouri. Funding for this grant comes through the Missouri Department of Agriculture from the USDA's Specialty Crop Block Grant Program, which is to strengthen the market for Missouri-grown specialty crops. As you look over the field, you can see that we have some differences, and that's because we have two objectives in this program. The first objective is to see if we can get an early enough watermelon production to hit the 4th of July market. And the second objective is an evaluation of a variety trial to know the performance of watermelon varieties in central Missouri. Missouri has a relatively short growing season to be able to get a mature watermelon for the 4th of July. For this reason, we have chosen a variety that takes a shorter amount of time to grow to full maturity, and that variety is Yellow Doll. It is a seeded watermelon, and it has a 68 to 70 day maturation. For the first objective, we are using covered rows. We have high tunnels, which our high tunnel style is known as the caterpillar tunnel. It's hoops that are actually top rails of a chain link fence, which are bent into the shape, and then they're covered with a plastic greenhouse film. The low tunnels, which are wire hoops, are covered with a thick row cover. The caterpillar tunnels are left up through harvest, while the row covers are removed when the female flowers begin appearing, and that's so that the pollinators can get into the flowers to pollinate them, whereas the sides on the caterpillar tunnels are opened up, which allows ventilation and also allows the pollinators to get inside. We have a control, and it does not have any cover on it. And these three treatments then are replicated four times. Ramon will now give you an update on the covered treatments.
I'm Ramon Arancibia, MBU Extension. I'm the horticulture specialist for the West Central region. So here we are to show the differences in growth in this trial on the early production of watermelon to hit the 4th of July market. And you can see here, this is our control with no cover. And I have to mention that these plants were planted right after the freeze last month, about April 23rd. And this is what they have grown with no cover, just the plastic mulch. And here we have some data loggers that are measuring the soil temperature in all three treatments. So we're having data on soil temperature, we're having data on air temperature to see the difference not only on the soil but the air temperature outside, inside the high tunnels, as well as inside the low tunnel that it was already removed. Yeah. But just in this chart here, you can see the difference in growth between the control with no cover and the high tunnel. Those high tunnels are already setting fruits. They have female flowers that have been set. There's already been a look into availability of bees, so we know they've been pollinated already. Yeah. This one here, they don't show flowers yet, so we are way ahead under the high tunnels. Yeah. And we're going to get closer to see the other ones over there too. Another thing that is important to understand is the larger the plant at the time most fruit set is going to be able to set more fruit. So in this case, if one or two fruits are set per plant, those fruits are going to compete with the growth, and these plants are going to grow slower than the ones of a deer that have a larger amount of foliage that can sustain more fruits. Yeah, so we expect to have more fruits on that one than here. In addition, hopefully to get them earlier than these ones here. And with that, we're gonna move closer. So here, and this is the control, and this is one of the largest plants. And although it has some flowers, these flowers are male flowers. Mainly, if you see the back of the flower, there is not a little fruit there. As we're gonna show you inside the high tunnels, that the female flower has a little fruit in the back of the flower. So these plants have not produced female flowers yet. That means they have quite a while still just to set fruit. So here we are inside the high tunnels, and you can see the difference in the large, how much they have grown, the plants, watermelon. And here I'm showing a female flower that is already open, ready to be pollinized. And you can see that it's female because of the back of the flower, it has a small fruit in there. So this is what we expect at this time. There are already several of these female flowers ready to be pollinated. Mm-hmm. And we hope if there are those pollinated right now, we are expecting to get the fruit by the 4th of July. All right, and here we have the plot that had the low tunnels and it has already been removed. One of the things that we wanna show when you have low tunnels, you better have a weed control system, whether herbicide or cultivation, whatever you decide to do, but because you see that not only the plants grow faster under the low tunnels, but the weeds also grow faster. So you wanna have a weed control method to avoid this competition. But in any case, the plants are larger than the ones that were not covered, the control that we showed before. Though these plants are larger, they still have not produced female flowers. So they're gonna start to produce female flowers soon. And the fact that they're larger, we expect them to set more fruits than the control, yeah? We hope that this one could set fruit soon so they can hit the 4th of July. We'll see, and if depending on how late from the 4th of July, we can determine a way to plant earlier and protect them from a possible freeze. Remember that this one were planted right after the freeze in April, and that was the 23rd of April. So keep in mind, if there is no freeze and we could have planted this 1 or 2 weeks earlier, these plants probably would have been having female flowers by now. And with that, we're gonna move to the variety trial and show you what's going on there. All right, and here we are in the variety trial test of this project. And you can see that the workers here in HARC have done a great job in marking the varieties so we know exactly which varieties do we have here. And we hope to bring people, or if people come and see these, they will know exactly which variety is growing in here. But the main purpose of this section is how these varieties perform in central Missouri. And we have in this particular test 15 varieties, seeded as well as seedless varieties. And there are the most common ones with a couple experimental varieties. Mm-hmm. They were just planted last week, so they look good. They're getting ready to kick off and grow now that temperatures are warm up. So we're in good shape, and hopefully in a couple months we can be here again to see a fruit set and production.
We would like to take this opportunity to thank the Missouri Department of Agriculture and the USDA for this grant. Thank you for watching this video. If you enjoyed this video, please make sure that you like, share, and subscribe to our channel, Mizzou Agroforestry.